Today I will explain what is the difference between resistance, reactance and impedance. This is part 2. Please watch part 1 before watching part 2. This is simple AC circuit. This is AC supply. Voltage is V. This is resistor and this is inductor. And I is the current flowing in this circuit like this. This I current will flow in this also, same current. Now, voltage across this resistor is VR, voltage across this inductor is VL. Then resistance of resistor is R. Similarly, inductance of inductor is L. And inductive reactance will be equal to omega L. So, inductor is the name of this and it had two values, one is inductance L, another is inductive reactance omega L. So, this is resistance, this is reactance, inductive reactance, then the impedance will be total from here to here and will be equal to square root R square plus L omega square. Here I have written omega L. Here I have written L omega, both are same. So value of impedance depends upon R, L, omega, where omega is equal to 2 pi f. F is the frequency of this supply, AC supply. Now suppose value of R becomes 0. This is 0. Then this will look like short. So I will short this. Now when R becomes 0, this function will not be there. So I will remove this function also. So impedance will be equal to L omega square. This square will be cancelled out with square root. Only L omega will be remaining. That is nothing but inductive reactance. So when R is equal to 0, so in this type of circuit, impedance and inductive reactance both will be equal and will be equal to omega L. Now suppose instead of R, L is 0. When L becomes 0, omega L also will become 0. And this will look like short. When this becomes short, there will not be any L omega because this value is 0. So I will remove this. So impedance will be equal to square root R square. This square will be cancelled out with square root. Only R will be remaining. That will be equal to resistance. So when this kind of circuit, when R and L both are there and value of L is 0, or you can say there is no L, then impedance and resistance will be equal and it will be R. Now, to calculate the value of R, resistance, using Ohm's law, we divide V by R. Here we take the voltage across this resistor, which is VR. So this voltage divided by this current, because current is same everywhere, will be equal to resistance. Similarly here, to get the inductive reactance, we take the voltage VL, which is across inductor. The voltage across inductor VL divided by current I is equal to omega L reactance. To calculate the impedance, we take full voltage because impedance is from here to here. So this full voltage V divided by I will be equal to impedance. In this circuit, I have shown C, capacitor in place of inductor. So capacitor is the name of this. It has two values. One is capacitance, that is equal to C, and another is capacitive reactance, that is equal to 1 by C omega. Here there is only one value. So resistance is R and capacitive reactance is 1 by C omega and impedance will be full, this plus this, and will be equal to square root R square plus 1 by C omega square. So impedance is depending upon R, C, omega, all three. Omega is same to pi f. Now suppose here I make R equal to 0. So this will become short. So here this factor will disappear like earlier. Now impedance will be square root 1 by C omega square. This square and this under root will be cancelled out. So remaining value will be 1 by C omega, that is nothing but this. So impedance and capacitive reactance will be same and equal and will be equal to 1 by C omega if in RC circuit value of R becomes 0. Now suppose I make capacitive reactance 1 by C omega 0. Now here C is here. To make this value 0, C should be infinite. So I write C is equal to infinite. In this case, when capacitive reactance is 0, this will show like short. Because reactance value is 0. So this factor becomes 0. So impedance will be equal to square root R square. 2 and square root is cancelled, only R is remaining. So in R and C case, if value of capacitive reactance becomes 0, then impedance and resistance becomes equal and will be equal to R. Now here, suppose we add one inductor also. Then value of impedance will not be this, it will change. It will be equal to square root R square plus L omega minus 1 by C omega square. Where this is reactance of inductor, this is reactance of capacitor. Now suppose this reactance and this reactance becomes equal, then they will cancel out. This is called the resonance and value of impedance will be equal to only R because this factor will not be there and this square and square root will cancel out. Today we will close here itself.